Dole wins in Iowa, rescue workers are cleaning up in Japan, and there may be a new twist for the Oklahoma City bombing trial. Hello, I'm Dina Herrera.
And I'm Wade Muehlhoff. Those stories and more, plus weather and sports ahead on Channel 19 News. A slab of rock that crushed a highway tunnel in Japan last Saturday still won't budge. Rescue workers have tried three times to blast away the 50,000-ton boulder, and they'll try a fourth time tomorrow. The boulder crushed a bus and a car and left 19 people are feared dead. Kansas City Senator Bob Dole has claimed victory in the Iowa caucus, where he took 26% of the vote. Conservative commentator Pat Buchanan had a strong showing. Thanks to support from Iowa's religious groups, Buchanan was in second place with 23%. Coming in third was former Tennessee Governor Lamar Alexander, who had 18% of the vote. Texas Senator Phil Graham had another poor showing, coming in fifth, winning support from only 9% of the Iowa voters. The next step for the candidates is New Hampshire, which will have the nation's first primary next week. Families of the Oklahoma bombing victims are pushing for TV cameras inside the trial of the suspects. Cameras and tape recorders are banned in federal courthouses, but attorney Karen Howick, working on behalf of the victims' families, says she's optimistic about getting an exception to that rule. Howick says the families want a closed-circuit broadcast of the trial of Timothy McVeigh and Terry Nichols. The blast last April killed 169 people and injured more than 500, and that means there are far more interested spectators than any federal courtroom could accommodate.
A 45-year-old man is the latest apparent victim of floods in the Pacific Northwest. Washington State officials say the man's body was found in a field near Everett yesterday, near his partly submerged truck. His death raises the toll from the floods to 8. Water levels in rivers and streams are going down, and the focus is shifting now to cleanup and repairs. Damage is expected to be in the hundreds of millions of dollars. President Clinton is scheduled to visit the area tomorrow to look at the flood damage. President Clinton has eliminated the ban of regulation for telecommunication industries. Channel 19's Jeremy Brevel has a story.
It's been a couple of weeks since President Clinton signed a telecommunication bill into law. Clinton hopes that the new law will generate more competition in the industries, creating more jobs and to protect the youth from a widespread of pornography and violence on the internet. SWT's Director of Computing Services, Robert Goss, says that he is neutral to the law because some points will help the societies while others may cause harm.
Whether you are for the intent or against the intent, the enforcement is not there over open networks that we have today. Even if it was, with the open network, you can easily get outside the United States. Those laws no longer apply.
Telecommunication industries are becoming more at risk with the word merger. MCI has already merged with Microsoft. AT&T wants to merge with MCI. And San Marcos's TCI Cable Company is trying to merge with Time Warner. Out of all the telecommunication industries, the cellular phone companies are sure to profit, since this bill will be pouring more money into new technology.
Even though there's a loosening in the government regulations in the telecommunications industry, many states are against this law due to the monopolizations of big companies. I'm Jeremy Brevel for Channel 19 News.
Coming up next, students can now park after 3 o'clock and construction for new restaurants is underway. Stay with us.
In 2 years, the Red Cross has responded to more major disasters than ever in our history. We've helped thousands of people get back on their feet again. But we depleted our reserves. We must raise millions of dollars to help disaster victims this year. Perhaps we helped you once, or a friend or a neighbor. If disaster strikes, we'll be there. The Red Cross is not a government agency. We depend on voluntary contributions from people like you. Please help us today so no one is left helpless later. Support Red Cross Disaster Relief.
Actor Martin Balsam is dead. He starred in such movies as On the Waterfront and 12 Angry Men. In 1965, he won a Best Supporting Actor for his role in the film A Thousand Clowns. A large, quiet man, Balsam often portrayed dependable and trustworthy characters. Balsam was found dead in a Rome hotel room today. He was 76.
San Marcos residents will soon have more choices as to where they can eat. Along with the opening of the new McDonald's, San Marcos will soon have a Red Lobster and a Mamacita's to add to its list of eateries. Even though it only took 2 months to build the new McDonald's, Red Lobster and Mamacita's won't be completed for some time. The Red Lobster will be San Marcos' first full-fledged seafood restaurant. Mamacita's, on the other hand, will have a lot of competition with many already existing Mexican restaurants. There has been no decrease in the amount of parking tickets issued to SWT students, despite the understaffing problems of the department is facing. With staffing problems only affecting office workers, UPD spokeswoman says issuing tickets is still a main priority. The amount of spots for commuters and carpool drivers has increased slightly, and UPD is now allowing all permit holders to park in any designated lot after 3 o'clock without receiving a ticket. The department is soon hoping to establish all zone lots for any permit holder on a first-come, first-served basis.
Valentine's Day is tomorrow, and local businesses are preparing for the wave of last-minute shoppers. Traditionally, flowers, chocolates, and greeting cards are the number one items on people's gift list. Randall's is overstocking these items in anticipation of a 1,000% increase in Valentine's Day sales. Bell's is focusing on a more intimate approach with a sale of women's lingerie, men's boxers, and fine jewelry. Regardless of the gift you choose for that special someone, they'll know it came from the heart.
After the break, Nicole Trainer will give the weather forecast outlook for the rest of the week.
If you think a college education is out of reach, the Army National Guard can put it within your grasp. With the Montgomery GI Bill, you can attend college full-time while serving in the Army National Guard. It's the best way to earn money for college while serving your country and your community. So join the Army National Guard. Earn the money you need for college and learn the skills you need for life. The Army National Guard, Americans at their best.
To have a dream, but never the chance to achieve it. That is perhaps the greatest tragedy in life. The United Negro College Fund exists to bring the dreams of thousands of young people within reach. Hands that yearn to touch lives. We train to heal, to teach, to bless. We encourage souls that hear music to write symphonies and sing anthems. And to those once bound by poverty, we present a wealth of possibilities. When you support the United Negro College Fund, you give more than money. You give dreams that may have died, the power to live.
Support the United Negro College Fund. A mind is a terrible thing to waste.
So, Nicole, how does the weather look like for the rest of this week?
The weather looks great. Today is a beautiful day. Tomorrow's going to be a lot of the same, but we might have some rain towards the end of the week. Let's take a look at our current conditions here in San Marcos. If you haven't gone outside today, make it a point to go out. It looks beautiful. Let's take a look at our Texas temperatures. Texas looks good. The temperatures are pretty much stable all across the state. National temperatures, as you can see, it's very warm, getting colder as we move northern. Let's take a look at our satellite picture. Clouds up there towards the Great Lakes. Now let's take a look at our extended forecast for the week. Tonight is going to be mostly cloudy with a low of 37. Tomorrow is going to be also mostly cloudy with a high of 73. Thursday is going to change to partly cloudy with a high of only 67, and we can maybe expect some rain on Thursday.
Well, SWT track team is headed for the Southland Conference Indoor Championships. Chris Baim is next with sports.
They've given our generation a label. X. Generation nothing. They say we have no sense of purpose. They say we have no war to fight and no cause to believe in. Who are they?
Join the thousands of us who are making a difference and wear a label that does mean something.
Southwest Texas baseball team's off to a good start. Right now, the Bobcats are 2-1 and are looking to improve on that record today when they take on the 1-1 Rice Owls in Houston. Coach Beauchamp would like to avenge last year's 5-1 loss to the Owls to get back some of that momentum to take into Houston this weekend when the Bobcats play the Cougars in a three-game series at Cougar Field. The Bobcats hope to improve their record against the Cougars because Houston leads the series 12-3, but split the series last year with 1-1. The SWT men's track and women's team are leaving tomorrow afternoon for Denton, and Coach Erickson hopes some of the talent from last year's team can pull its weight in order for their team to do well at the meet. The University of Texas at Arlington is favored to win the championship, but the Bobcats feel they still have some old tricks up their sleeve, and they feel that they're the team to look out for in this championship meet. Both men's and women's basketball teams will begin a four-game home stretch on Thursday against Northwestern State. The 12-8 women's team will start off the doubleheader with a 5:20 tip-off featuring SWT's fourth all-time scoring leader, Yolanda Wilkerson. The 10-10 men's team will begin their game later at 7:35. Dante Mathis, with his 9-point-per-game average, is considered by many to be the SLC Freshman of the Year. This would be the second freshman to win the award here at SWT in 3 years. Damian Sampson won the award 2 years ago. In college hoops, we had some blowouts and some upsets. Number 7 Utah loses a heartbreaker to Wyoming by the score of 78-76. The Utes led by as many as 14 points with 14 minutes left in the game. But the free throw shooting of Wyoming was the key for pulling out the upset. The Cowboys were 10 of 7 in the final 7 minutes of the game. Number 4 Villanova kills LaSalle by 40 points in a 90-50 so-called contest. I wonder what UMass will do to LaSalle because they play each other this Thursday. Here's a highlight from last night's game between number 16 Syracuse and Rutgers. Check out the dish from Santiago to McCrimson. Ouch. Syracuse wins the game 63-54.
Chris, sounds like a lot's going on SWT sports. Anything local in the high schools?
Well, to be quite honest with you, yeah. The San Marcos High School boys team are going to be in Bastrop. That begins about 7:30, and the girls are at New Braunfels. They're just about to get underway right now. And also the state-bound San Marcos High Rattlers softball team, they're going to be in Georgetown tonight. The game's going to be about 7:15.
All right, well, hopefully a lot of people go out and support the local teams.
Mm-hmm. Thanks, Chris.
You bet.
Scientists at Columbia Presbyterian Health Center want to know if indeed laughter is the best medicine. So they're conducting a study involving Dr. Stubbs, Dr. Tickle, and Dr. Noodles. Today they're visiting with 5-year-old Sean Mellon, who has pneumonia. But the clowns believe they have proof enough that patients and their parents feel better after one of their visits. The medical study will continue for 1 year. Well, Valentine's Day is tomorrow, so Chris, what are you going to get your wife?
I'm going the cheap route. I'm thinking I'm just going to give her a massage.
Oh, gosh.
There you go.
Well, at least it has a personal touch to it.
No pun intended.
Yeah. Of course not. For Wade, Chris, Nicole, and all of us here at Channel 19 News, have a great afternoon and a happy Valentine's Day.